ESPN with Bill Clement. I'm Gary Thorne. We're ready to go. Great matchup coming your way tonight.
Well, it's great to be in this building in Philadelphia. Some of the most loyal fans in the National Hockey League, and they've known that for the last few years, the Flyers have been banging on the door of the Stanley Cup. Again this season, they look like they're poised to make a run.
Veteran defensemen really add to the way a club plays. Two blue liners in this game tonight bring along a lot of years and a lot of experience.
You know, Jason Smith is just a workhorse. Doesn't matter if you need him 25 minutes, 30 minutes a game. He just seems to work without effort. I don't know, he might be able to play 40 minutes some night. And Gary, when we look at Eric Desjardins, I think we're looking at one of the most consistent defensemen in the game today. And one thing he does, I think, better than anybody, he gets to pucks into the corners quicker than any defenseman in the game.
The Flyers are one of the league's best offensive clubs. They've got great speed, stick handling ability, and they've got the snipers to finish it.
Well, Gary, not only is this team good offensively, they are a disciplined team. They're hardly ever in the penalty box.
Win the faceoff. Deeks, his man, gets by. LeClaire can't convert on that shot attempt. Over to Smith. Nedved, center ice. Back to the point. To Dvorak. Shot from the right side. He controls the puck in the neutral zone. Desjardins gains possession in the defensive end. Broken up by Dvorak. From Amonte to LeClaire. LeClaire shoots from the left wing.
Oh, timing was perfect. Laid the body down. Good shot block to keep the game tied. Eric Brewer's really developed into a solid defenseman. That's one of the reasons he played for Canada at the Salt Lake City Olympics.
Conklin races for the faceoff near his goal. Get control of the puck in the offensive end. Recchi with the puck in the corner. The Oilers pick up the loose puck in the defensive zone. Cross passes it across to Hemsky. Sends it to the defenseman. Markov up with a pass through center. Now the puck through center ice. Conklin save! That one bottom left, no room. Jamnov from Gagne. He's in the corner. Jamnov goes behind the net.
Conklin got this one with the twig. He was in the stand-up position and was able to flash the lumber out and make the save. Tonight's NHL game is being presented in ESPN Game Sound, designed and developed in collaboration with Dolby.
The linesman will drop the puck to the goalie's right. Passes to the left wing. Primo grabs the puck in the neutral zone.
Oh, man, did he get nailed, Gary. Classic hip check. Hey, take a seat for a while. Chill.
Ulanov passes to the right wing. 34. His shot completely misses the goal. Oh, can't believe it. His shot just broke the glass. And they're ready for the faceoff. It's poke checked away. Smith pokes it away.
Chico Esch with a terrific display of athleticism, folks. He was in the stand-up position, so he was still able to flash the pad. That's how he made the save.
The faceoff is left to the goalie. Wing over to the left wing. Rona hits pressure, gives it back.
Hey, well, there's a nice souvenir. There's nothing like coming to a game when you're a kid and going home with a puck.
Conklin camps out at the left of the goal. Off the player, up into the glass. Sanderson to Hansen. He scores, and they grab the 1-0 lead. Solid effort in this first period at home.
Oh, how do you handle this if you're a goalie? Check out this one-timer goal. I mean, it's tough enough for the goalie to stop a one-timer. When the crossbar is on the side of the shooter, you are flat-out stuck.
Shooters would like to say they practiced that, Bill, but I guarantee you they could stand there all day and not do that practice.
You're right. They'd be lying if they told you they practiced it off the crossbar.
And they're getting ready for the face-off as the players get set around the face-off dot. The Flyers have a one-goal lead now here on the first period. Jacks to expand at the one. It's saved by Conklin. What a moment. Brewer fires out a pass, but to no one.
I don't think there's any mistake about this one. It sure looked like a cross check, even from up here. We'll show you the replay, and let's see exactly what the refs saw.
There's what the refs saw. Stick up and both hands on it.
Is his team's favorite guy at the center of the penalty box. All you got to do is check the numbers. He leads this team in penalty minutes so far this season.
Conklin in goal, ready on the right side for the faceoff. Bill, this has been a great one-goal game, and these fans hoping they can make it, too, with the help of the noise that they're leveling.
Boy, it's electric, and the fans are helping that cause, but I'll tell you what, it's still pretty tense with only a one-goal lead.
LeClaire has it in the corner.
Love this save, and it's a huge Gary. If he doesn't make it, the situation goes from bad to worse. You gotta love the emotion that Jeremy Roenick brings to the locker room. I mean, he can get guys fired up. He brings fans to their feet. He is the entire package, the complete player.
Skaters look like they're set around the circle here as we get set for the drop of the puck in this draw. The Oilers get the puck still in the PK with a one-man disadvantage. Esch sends it to the defenseman. LeClaire over to Shamnov. The puck is being carried by Roenick. Shamnov, his shot misses the goal. It's passed to the point. Roenick fires a rope from the right side. Pulls off a move. The Flyers pick up the loose puck at center ice. To Recchi from Roenick. It goes to the defenseman. Over to Horkov. The Flyers clear the puck out of their end. The Oilers trail by one here in the first period of tonight's game. What's going out there on the ice right now for this club?
Well, Gary, so far I think these guys have had pretty good goaltending. I think the numbers bear that out, but it's going to get a little serious here if they don't get more offense for him. He is going to be the focal point of this game.
Oh, what an excellent poke check. That stops a scoring opportunity. The Flyers make the D change here. Smith dishes the puck through center ice. He pulls off the move. Along the corner, Smith sends it careening around the boards. Taking some elbow. Kapanen bangs the puck out of the zone, clearing effort works. The Flyers are going to get some fresh skaters out there on the ice, changing up forwards. Nedved takes the puck through the zone.
Oh, technique on this save. A point-blank shot. He was set. His blocker was in the right spot, and he made the save.
Poke checked away by Smith. That play gets broken up. Good effort on the poke check. Controls it in. He scores! They go ahead by two goals. There's a big goal here in the first.
Hey, I think this was a pretty good decision. The screen is set up in front. I'm not sure the goalie can see it. Just take the shot. It might find its way in.
Bill, great positioning on this. You wait long enough so you've got somebody in front of you. You got a better chance to put it home.
Yeah, you bet. Sometimes the screens are too big if there are too many guys in front. This was perfect.
Absolutely on the money. The impact of goal. And here Here comes the faceoff. We'll start action up again with this drop of the puck. The Flyers win the faceoff and the lead up 2 goals here in their home ice. Desjardins controls the puck in the defensive end. Breaks the dot. Hemsky gains control of the loose puck in the offensive zone. Torres controlling the puck in the corner. Desjardins and a superb defensive play. That poke checks away the opportunity.
Amonte gets his first free pass to one of the best seats in the house, that is, unless the other guy score on the power play. How about this? The crowd wants more. They are chanting their hometown boys on, and they're already ahead by two.
Still realizing this game is doable for the opposition. Rocking, taking the roof off, having a good time. That's what this crowd's doing right now.
Yeah, you talk about momentum. This is sometimes how it starts.
Puck is cleared. Power play still underway. Kongkong dishes out to the right wing. Torres holding the puck in the neutral zone. Torres sends the pass, but no one can get to it. He centers it. They clear it out. Time winding down on the penalty. Under a minute on the power play chance. He passes it up the right side. To Torres. Takes a move. Markov clears it out of the zone on the PK unit. From Cross to York. The puck directed out towards center. Along the right wall. Controlled by Torres. Markov feeds it across ice to Hansus. Tries a deep. Passes it to the right wing. He gets poke checked. Radivojevic to Amandi. And we're at the 2 minute mark of the period. He feeds it up the right side. Dvorak feeds to the left side. Dvorak from Smith. Dvorak with a puck along the boards. Dvorak. Esch. Save! He lets that one go by. This is a one-goal game. He doesn't. Still up by two. Gagne, unable to do much. Under pressure. Passes it back to Recchi. What a move. And the shooting lane clog. What a dive. Over to Ragnarsson. From Pitkinen. Dvorak. Roughing it up a little at center ice.
Boy, I love this poke check because they stopped an offensive play from developing before it even got on the drawing board. Oh, how sweet was that poke check, Gary? I mean, he knew exactly when to move, and he timed it perfectly.
Has it, center ice. 35 seconds showing on the game clock. Esch with a save. Esch makes the pass to the defenseman. Save that shot, met up with his pads. From Pitkinen, over to Gagne. It's controlled along the wall by Gagne. And a save by Conklin. Gagne gets the puck out. Not a good pass. Smith feeds the puck up the left ice. A long pass. Save! That one headed to the top left by Esch. Dvorak with the poke check. It shot from the left side. The buzzer sound signaling the end of the first. We've got a score of 2-0. The Flyers had the early lead in the first and maintained their game, coming out here to start the second with a 2-goal advantage. How are they pulling that together tonight?
Well, Gary, the advantage here is in the stats when you look at offensive zone time. I mean, they're playing a good strategic game out there, and it's paid off with the 2-goal lead. The more breathing room you give yourself, the better off you are in the long run.
They look ready to start the second period now. The Flyers win the faceoff to start the second period. Along the left wall, now it's controlled by Dvorak. Janssen holding him, got him along the wall. Gagne uses a quick poke check, disrupts the opportunity. Taking some abuse, maybe enough for a call. Nedved picks up the loose puck at center ice. He fires it back.
Oh, up by two, and he's still preserving it with a little help from his best friend, the post.
And center ice, now it's taken by Gagne. The Flyers are able to make the switch. Defensive change over the boards. Behind the goal. Shamnov in.
Oh, you gotta like this save. You use every body part and every part of your equipment. This time it was the skate that stopped the wrist shot.
Smith puts the puck through center. Up through the zone. Markov passes it to the right wing. The Flyers wanted to make a line change at forwards coming over the boards. Four of that change right now. Torres with the puck at center ice. And now on the slot. He scores! The rebound came out and then pushed it back into the net.
Oh, you got to check this out. Right place at the right time. I mean, you never know where the rebound's headed. It came right to him, and he made him pay.
Bill, you get those as an offensive player because you stay with it. Focus. Stay in the play. You back up. You never get that chance.
Yeah, you just hope it comes out on the forehand side.
They're ready to drop the puck. The Oilers win the faceoff, down by three. The Flyers pick up the loose puck at center ice. 34 sends it up through the center. The Flyers get the loose puck in their own end. Fires from the right side. He makes the save. Amonte uses a quick poke check that'll interrupt that play. Ronan really reacted to the checking that's been going on with their star player throughout this game. He's been a target out there, and I think they're fed up with it.
Well, Gary, he had to know that there was a bullseye on him after he hit the star player. I mean, you've got to protect your skilled guys. Once you start throwing your body around nailing the skilled guys, you know somebody's going to come after you.
Ronan started the fight, but he ends up being the loser as far as the brawl's concerned, and maybe even more.
Oh, Gary, this really could work against them. If you're the aggressor and your team's ahead, you want to win the fight so you don't squash your own momentum.
The Skaters will face off left of the net. The Flyers in the lead. Three goals here at home in front of a very pleased home crowd. To the point. Primo manages to get it out. Under pressure, sends it out of the corner. Capitan takes it behind the net. And the puck is controlled by Capitan. Smith controls the puck in the defensive end.
Oh, that's a pretty good poke check right there. I mean, the guy wasn't in great scoring position, but you got to get the puck to transition, and he did.
Down in the corner, Primo, puck handling, Primo.
Oh, this is a good collision. Remember, this guy isn't known for his hitting ability. He did a pretty good job here in open ice.
He feeds it through center.
Oh, he had the bullseye picked out on this guy's back. He crushed them.
From Pickett and Ragnarsson. Primo from Ragnarsson. The Flyers changing up forwards over the boards. Steos makes the long left side pass. The shot. Esch grabs the shot. Quick pump check to break up the play by Nedved.
Bulldozer central. I think it might have been the element of surprise. We don't know this guy for the big open ice hits.
It's saved by Esch. And that trip down the ice, a couple of opportunities, both stopped. The puck hit up the right side. Dvorak sends the puck up center ice. Malikov feeds the puck across ice to Amonte. And here's a 2-on-0 opportunity. Amonte in the slot. Ulano is going to have the delay penalty call coming up.
All right, the replay of the slashing penalty. Yeah, he really took a swat at him. I mean, he went lumberjack on him and got called 2 minutes, and it's a good one.
Not only designed to keep the offensive flow going, but obviously the injuries. You take that slashing call back of the wrist across the top of the glove, you can really do some damage.
Yeah, without question, a stick is a potential weapon.
The faceoff on the right side of the goalie.
Big goal nights like this, so rare in the National Hockey League, Bill, and this crowd's loving it.
And right now the fans are saying, hey guys, you're following our script.
Broken up with a poke check. Folks, if you weren't aware, we'd like to take a moment. ESPN celebrating the 25th anniversary, Bill, of great sports broadcast.
And Gary, I know we speak for both of us when we say proud to be a part of it.
The Flyers win the faceoff on the power play. Jenna over to Roenick. It's control right side along the boards. By Janssen. Conklin makes the save and the shorthanded shot. It's cleared out. Penalty killing unit doing what they have to do on the ice right now. Over to Roenick from Recchi. Taken through the zone by Jamnoff. Morrow under pressure sends out the puck. No one there to get it. Orkov feeds it out of pressure up the right side. Jamnoff center ice. And it's tipped away. Jamnoff. Nice play at center. He's controlling the puck at center ice. Hemsky sends a long pass up the left side. Torres brings the puck up. The Oilers get the chance to switch lines. They wanted to swap deep pairs.
Hey, they're really good acrobats in the NHL if their goalies have to do that out of necessity, because sometimes with their aggressiveness, they're a little out of position. If you're not an acrobat, you're going to get scored on.
Esch gets set to defend as they face off to his right. The Oilers win the draw, still trailing by three, though. Torres passes the puck in the center to Yor. Esch slay going left side low. Nothing down there to shoot at.
Chico Esch is really playing well here tonight. And guess what? These chances can go the other. Tonight, it's a positive chance.
This building is really pumped up right now. You get a three-goal lead like this, the fans sense maybe that's going to be enough. Markov uses his stick. The Flyers grab the loose puck in their own end. The Flyers make the D change here. Bergeron picks up the loose puck in his own zone. He digs. The Flyers get control of the puck in the offensive end. They clear the puck. Brashear checked at center ice. Kapanen sends it right side. Out of pressure. He gets the save. The puck goes to the defenseman. To Hemsky. Rolling off. Almost a hook. At least it looked like it. The Oilers wanted to get a line change here. Offensive lines will change. They've got an opportunity. Scores and another goal here in the second, up by four.
All right, we're going to see this guy pick up another assist. He's number five on the team. It's a secondary assist, but it's an important part of the play. If you don't make this play stick, the whole thing breaks down.
And, Bill, this is choreographed a little bit. By that, I mean it's one of those plays that's designed to happen this way, to get the puck out of the zone.
Yeah, you start tape to tape, then you go tape to tape, then you go tape to twine.
Great way to finish with the goal. It's time to get this game going again. Here's the puck drop. The Oilers have control of the puck.
Flyers
neutral zone area. The Flyers pick up the loose puck in the defensive zone. LeClaire has it center ice. Smith gets control of the puck in his own end. Lispister under pressure passes it back to number 36.
Great poke check by Ragnarsson.
Ragnarsson gains possession in the defensive end. Over to Roenick, and we're at the two-minute mark of the period. The Oilers have possession of the puck in the defensive zone. Shoots! Pitkinen picks up the loose puck in his own zone. Controlled at center. Pokes it away. 36 grabs the puck in the neutral zone.
loses the puck on a poke check.
1 minute remaining in the period.
Esch relays the puck back to the defenseman. Gates the puck, taking no chances here.
John LeClair's home on the ice is right in front of the opposing goal. And I mean, is there anybody else you'd rather have there than him?
Esch protecting the left side of the net. Clock shows we've got 51 seconds.
Oh, this is a stick save and a pretty good one off that wrist shot, Gary. We know it's tough to pick it up coming off the stick. You don't telegraph at all when you wrist a puck.
Bill, these fans with a goalie chant. Sometimes goalies say they don't hear this kind of stuff, but when it's positive, you gotta hear it.
Yeah, you really do. Most important position in all of sports, and the fans are getting their money's worth tonight.
Over to the point. 34 is in the corner. DeSteos. The Flyers have possession of the puck in the defensive zone. 34 gets his stick on the loose puck. Recchi with a superb defensive play, poke checking that away. 15 left to go on the game clock. They're getting ready for the faceoff to the left side of the goalie. The Flyers win the faceoff, and they're just putting on a show here tonight. Powerful effort. The puck is in the corner. Solnik holds him along the boards. Radivojevic scales the boards. And that signals the end of the second period with the score 4-0. The Flyers are continuing their great play here tonight, Bill. It's been a pretty one-sided affair so far. They got the big lead early, continuing to control the game as we start the third. What has excelled in your mind for them?
Well, Gary, I don't know. I think this guy in goal can really play a little better. I mean, he hasn't brought his A game tonight. Fortunately for him, the Snipers have brought their A game. These guys are piling it up on the scoreboard, so nobody's talking about goaltending.
The players are set for the faceoff. And a poke check that'll lock the puck free. Roenick poke checks. Poke check forced by Nedved. Controlled in the defensive zone by Smith. Smith puts the puck through center in the slot. And a save with a stick by Esch. Nedved holds the puck in the corner. The corner. Amonte checks him in the corner. It's broken up. Nice poke check there. Amonte collects the puck off the long pass. Smith sends a long pass up the left side. The Flyers switch up on their offensive line. The Oilers switch up the defensive pairings. Johnson is under pressure and sends it back to his defenseman. He passes to the defenseman. Johnson tries a D. Johnson over to Recchi. Over to Gagne from Recchi. Carrying the puck along the boards, controlled by Gagne.
Oh, man, we are talking about flashing some leather right there.
Recchi with the puck in the corner. Recchi a little roughed up in the corner by Steos.
Boy, this guy was looking to get off the shot, and you know what? The poke check was perfect. No scoring chance.
He passes it up the right side. Markov, under pressure, passes up the right side. Carried it into the corner. Steos, what a poke check. Good use of the stick. Gagne in the corner. Gagne disrupts the offense. Beautiful poke check. Steos clears it out of the zone. The Oilers change shifts for their defenseman. The puck tipped away. Recchi forced to pass the puck back to Pitkinen. Carried in the neutral zone by Zhanov. The Flyers bring out a new set of forwards looking for a goal here. Over to York. Over to the right wing. Ragnarsson makes the long left side pass. He brings the puck up. Orkov, poke checks. Makes the move. Poke check by Kapanen. Brewer passes back to the defenseman. Smith passes the puck to the right wing. To Horkov. Orkov from the right side. It's blocked. He dropped to his knees to make that play. Esch smothers the shot for the save. From Esch, Ragnarsson. The pass, no good. The Flyer with the icing call.
Oh, check this replay out. I mean, this is a dangerous play. You drop to the knees. If the shooter gets the puck a little too high, you get nailed. I mean, on this one, he survived.
And Bill, once you've gone down in your knees, there's no more reaction to be had because you're not going to be able to get back up before that shot's taken.
Esch can't let the cheap one by. You can bet he's going to protect the left side of the net here. Oh, what a poke check to disrupt the opportunity. Amonte passes the puck to center. LeClaire from Roenick has it along the boards. Deeks. The Flyers grab the puck in the neutral zone.
You know, you gotta love this guy's positioning. He's a terrific position goaltender, even when he's forced to move. I mean, we talk about being square to the shooter. Try to push off one post, get all the way over to the top of the crease on the other side, and be square and well positioned. Watch this guy do it.
Running away with this one, placing the home fans. The puck off the faceoff. Ispas picks it up for loose puck and center ice.
Oh, wow. He hit him like a tank, Gary.
Roenick has had an exchange of words already tonight. Not happy about some pushing. There was some additional contact, a little shoving went on out there. I think this thing finally just boiled over.
Yeah, Gary, you could see it building little by little and finally, bang.
Happened so often, that's why I thought start.
Roenick started the fisticuffs, Bill, and looked as though he couldn't finish it off.
But Gary, I guess he got what he deserved on this one because he started the fight and his team's ahead. We'll see if they can hold this lead.
We'll get back to the action now. The ref gets ready to drop the puck. And the puck gets tipped away. Somek got punished at center ice by Dvorak. Janssen passes across ice to Radivojevic. Somek with a poke check to break up the play. Radivojevic getting held up along the wall. Brewer gets the puck out. Not a good pass. Janssen is getting pressured. Sends the puck back to his D. Somek passes it up through center ice. Hanzus over to Radivojevic. Radivojevic behind the goalie.
Coach doesn't want a penalty, seeing too much stick work there.
You know, I don't know of many players in the NHL that can control the wall, control that area along the boards and in the corners, as well as Ryan Smith. Some way, somehow, he always finds a way to come out of the corner with the puck.
They'll face off just right of the goalie. Gets the puck away with a poke check. The Flyer regain control on the offensive. Conklin, stick save. LeClaire with a poke check. Sends it to the defenseman. A defender's best friend, the poke check. That one worked. The Oilers have possession at center ice. Markov sends it right side, out of pressure. The Flyers are called for icing.
You know, I think a lot of people think of Alexei Zhamnov as strictly an offensive player. You watch, a lot of the coaches he has played for have played him against the top offensive players on the other team. That's how good he is defensively.
The linesman will start the action to the goalie's left. Morrow passes to the right wing. Esch, save that one headed low right. The puck is in the corner. Morrow
carries the puck. He scores!
The shot went off the goalie's left pad and in.
Boy, Gary, I got to see this again. I thought he had his pad on the right angle, but I don't know, somehow the puck got a chunk of it and then flopped in.
Bill, I don't think he was set where he wanted to be on this. He was still moving. As a result, that redirection that he attempted was the wrong way.
Yeah, you're probably right. He wasn't square, was he?
And they're ready for the faceoff. The Oilers get the puck, still down by three on the road. Good shot. And the save made by Ish. Johnson moves it over to Amonte. From Amonte. Poke check for Sijamnov. To Amonte from LeClaire. The Oilers get the loose puck in their own end. 34 controlling the puck at center ice. The Oilers change shifts. The skaters coming out of the ice. Through the zone, handled by LeClaire. To the point. From LeClaire, over to Amonte. Conklin makes the stick save to stop the one-timer.
Hey, no time to be Mr. Nice Guy here. That's the way to clear bodies out in front.
From number 34, to Moreau. He scores again! And they are coming fast and furious. That's two in a row in less than 3 minutes.
Oh, I want to see this one again, Gary. I mean, it was well executed. One-timers have to be perfectly executed. But where was the D on this play? This guy was in a dangerous scoring position.
I agree, Bill. Rarely do you get a guy open in the middle area of the ice like that, down in the slot as low as he was.
Gary, he was so open, he would have had time for his own rebound. He didn't need it on this one, though.
And they're getting ready for the faceoff as the players get set around the faceoff dot. The Flyers get the faceoff. They're up by two here in their own house. Steos gains possession in the defensive end.
Assisted by
Esch, saving it. He keeps that two-goal lead alive for his club. Rashier from Primo. Down the right side, the puck handled by Rashier. Steos over to Hemsky. Over to York from Steos. Torres with a deke. Torres fires a rope from the left side. Esch saved. Right spot, right time, slap shot hit him. The puck hit up the right side. Pokes it away. The puck to the left. He scores! It's in off the right pad and to the back of the twine.
Is a man that just executed a crazy play. How awesome is this? On the replay, you'll see he froze everybody with the fake shot, then feathered the one-time pass. Execution at the end. Oh, man, this is a tremendous play.
Bill, give it a chance. The goaltender would just assume walk out of the net and just watch the puck go in and say, tip my hat, it's yours.
I mean, how many things could have gone wrong for the goalie on that play? I mean, everything did.
We've got a face-off coming up. Teams moving into position here as they get set to drop the puck. The Flyers have really given themselves some breathing room here. That last goal puts them up three, third period. Now they really can sit back and just play some terrific defense, and that ought to be enough. Countdown continues, a minute 36 left on the game clock.
Hey, you got to have possession to score goals now.
He scores on a wraparound chance.
Boy, I want to see this replay again. A beautiful goal on the wraparound, but I don't think the goalie had a clue which side he was going to come out. Otherwise, he would have been down on the butterfly trying to seal off the post. He was still standing in the crouch.
And because he was, Bill, that created the scoring chance here because there was some room to shoot.
Yep, you bet. He saw twine and he nailed it.
Skaters getting set now as the official moves into position. Ready for this faceoff as he gets set to drop the puck. The Oilers win the draw, trailing here by two. Great breakup of the puck check at center ice. Smith gets drilled at center ice. 56 seconds remaining, plenty of time left in the period. The deep. The Flyers collect the puck in the neutral zone.
Of the third period.
The Oilers pick up the loose puck in the defensive zone. Solmik, unable to do much under pressure, passes it back to Radivojevic. To Pitkinen from Radivojevic. Pitkinen uses his stick. Smith is knocked off the puck after getting checked by Radivojevic. The Oilers grab the loose puck at center ice. Smith able to send the puck out. Ragnarsson under pressure, passes up the left side. He shoots from the left side, checking with 19 seconds left to go. Controlling the puck along the boards by Somek. Dvorak pulls him tight against the wall. Puck frozen against the boards. Conklin races for the faceoff near his goal. Dispister pulls off a move to the right wing. Over to 36. 6 seconds left. The puck hit up the left side. Johnson controls the puck in the defensive end. Bulanov gets the loose puck at center ice. And the buzzer sounds the end of the third period with a score 5-3. Exhibition game tonight. On behalf of Bill Clement and all of our crew, I'm Gary Thorne. Thanks for joining us, everybody. The regular season's not far away, and we'll see you there.